It's cold for a summer night. I text you, I'm sorry, I don't mean to bother, but figured I gotta try. And you say you're busy, but I don't believe you, it's keeping me up at night. The way my emotions keep turning around, keep it inside.
Felicia, as they lead the procession up.
Cause I wanna be loved by you, you. I wanna be loved by you, you. Cause I wanna be.
What's up, guys? Welcome back. Hope you have an amazing day. Today, one of my boys is getting married. Really close boy for like 30 years. Amazing buddy. We're gonna be heading out to his wedding and we're gonna check it out. It's gonna be on Spruce Wood Winery Estates. Me and my brother are all decked out in suits. We got his brother down there decked out in a pimped out pink suit. So we're about to get ready. We're on the shuttle right now, getting head out to Amherstburg. Hold on, let me show you what he's got right now. Check that out. Look at this.
Talonor, his brother's pimped out, ready to go.
Yeah, he's pimped out, ready to go. He's got that pink, that lavender pimp in it. Oh.
Show.
That pastel pink. It matches the wedding. That's beautiful. Look at the bandana print tie. Oh man. Don't know what to say. Ladies, wait in line for him. Wait in line for him. He's got a long list, alright? Just kidding. Just playing around. Alright guys, so right now, I'm happy that we found the right shuttle because we got here and it's raining outside, as you guys can see. And they were calling like thunderstorms and tornado watch and all that stuff, but I heard that was actually pretty good luck. Who knows though, superstitions. But we're gonna be heading out to the wedding. Enjoy the wedding. There's gonna be lots of people showing up there. Hope you guys enjoy this. Stay tuned. Thank you.
You're welcome.
It is tan. This place is nice. Look at Calvin. What's up, bro? How you doing, bro?
Wow, doing good, man.
Oh, what's up, bro? Out, man.
Anybody know how to tie a bow tie?
Hey, what's up, bro? I don't know how to do one.
Well, how about all the chairs?
The rain killed him.
Oh, it was
a big storm.
The rain killed it.
I'm going to focus on that. There we go. Yeah, that's real nice. The rain killed it.
It'd be too muddy.
Yeah.
Are you all going?
Alright guys, ceremony is starting in 5 minutes. Here's the guest list right here. This is pretty cool. So as you guys can see, right there, me and my brother are at table 6. That's pretty cool how they got out of the glass mirror. They can keep it forever. Beautiful.
Zero to receive.
Ladies and gentlemen, I invite you to please stand to greet our bride. Please be seated. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Sprucewood Shores Estate Winery. On this slightly overcast day, I don't know if you are aware, but if it rains on your wedding day, it's a sign of good luck. Did you know that? It is. That's traditional. So you have the beginning of good luck right from the start of your wedding, so that's good news. Regardless of what it's doing outside, we're here today, and it's a beautiful day to be together. And speaking of beautiful, do we not have an absolutely beautiful bride here? What do you think? Come on. So I've got to admit, since I first met Troy, boy, can he clean up. In fact, the whole wedding party, the kids, Noah, and everybody else here, you did a tremendous job, and especially our little sign bearer there. My name is Joe McFarland, and it is my distinct honor today to be with all of you on this important day in their lives. And it's their love story. And it's been quite a love story up until now, and today represents a brand new chapter in that love story starting. And that's why all of you are here, because in some way or another, in the past, you've been part of that love story. Otherwise, I'm not sure why you're here. But they still have many more chapters to write in their story together, and they are glad to have you here today, but they look forward to all the tomorrows that you will be with them to support them and to love them as husband and wife until their final story is complete. So welcome, friends and families and honored guests. We are here today to celebrate love. Love which organizes our large and sometimes unpredictable world. It is that which enshrines and ennobles our human experience. It is the basis for the peace of the family and peace of the peoples of the earth. The greatest gift bestowed upon humans is the gift of love freely given between two persons. In marriage, two people turn toward each other in search of greater fulfillment than either can achieve alone. Marriage is a bold step. It is a bold step taken together into an unknown future. It is risking who we are for the sake of who we can be. Only in giving of ourselves fully and sharing our lives with another can the mysterious process of growth take place. Only in loyalty and devotion bestowed upon another can that which is eternal in life emerge and be known. Two among us, Troy and Felicia, who have stood apart, come together now to declare their love and to be united in marriage. Troy, Felicia, the words I say today, they have no magic or prophetic powers. The power of the wedding vows is a reflection that already exists in each of your hearts, souls, and minds. Troy and Felicia, nothing I can say or nothing you can say to each other will ensure a long and happy, satisfying, and committed marriage. Only your love for one another and your integrity to make your commitment real can do that. and Felicia are not here by chance or happenstance. They're here as the result of loving parents and families and friends who have helped nurture them throughout the years to bring them to this point in their lives. Because even though marriage is a coming together of two people and a celebration of the love of two people, it is so much more than that. The love that Troy and Felicia have for one another is the flowering of a seed that their parents planted in their hearts so many years ago. Today, as they embrace one another and their love for each other, they also embrace the families, all of you, which have come together to celebrate with them on this happy occasion. And so as a sign of their love for their families, Troy and Felicia have chosen to present roses to their mothers, Wendy and Kim, as symbols of their eternal love. So I ask both mothers to please come and stand next to your respective child. Maybe I can bring you up just a little bit this way. So, okay, perfect. You can stand there, perfect. Wendy and Kim, Troy and Felicia would like both of you to know that your efforts throughout the years were not in vain. So that begs the question, were there any efforts? Just a few? Lots? And they thank you for your love and support because it is so very much appreciated by them. They thank you for everything that you've instilled in them. They have represented roses to you, and these roses are a promise that no matter how far away you ever are, that you are never forgotten. And they are a reminder that you are always in their hearts. Please present roses to your mothers. And then, so hold on now, folks. And hug each other's mothers. Just don't step on their breasts. And mothers, if you're so inclined, you want to hug each other, you can hug each other. Why not? Here we go. Thank you, mothers. Please be seated. The couple have elected to have this very short but very powerful reading that's entitled Once in a Lifetime. And as I share these words with you, please understand they're not my words to you. We haven't met. They are the words that Troy has in his heart for Felicia and that Felicia has in her heart for Troy. So these are their words to one another. Once in a lifetime, you find someone special. Your lives intermingle, and somehow you know that this is the beginning of all that you have longed for. A love you can build on, a love that will grow. Once in a lifetime, to those who are lucky, a miracle happens and dreams all come true. I know it can happen because it happened to me. I have found my once in a lifetime with you. How many people believe that they have found their once in a lifetime? What do you think?
Yeah, I think.
Yeah.
Let's hear some applause. Well, Troy and Felicia, you're standing here in front of a lot of friends and family, and I need to know from a legal perspective why you're standing here. So I have to ask a couple of questions, for which one or two word answers are good. I will. And if you get those individual questions right, I'm going to have a bonus third round question for the two. Does that sound good? You remember we practiced this? Troy, you've chosen Felicia to be your wife. Will you love and respect her? Will you be modest with her always? And will you stand by her through whatever may come? Felicia, you've chosen Troy to be your husband. Will you love and respect him? Will you be honest with him always? And will you stand by him through whatever may come?
I will.
Well, now the bonus third round question. and you, Troy and Felicia, both promise to make the necessary adjustments in your personal lives in order that you may live in a harmonious, loving, and nurturing relationship together.
We do.
Good answer. I'm going to invite you, the two of you, to come and stand right underneath here so we have this right above you. Okay, that sounds just looks perfect. Okay. So I'm going to ask you now to join your hands and look at each other. And as your hands are joined, you also join your hearts. And since Troy won the coin flip, he goes first. No, we can't say that. I, Troy, take you, Felicia.
I, Troy, take you, Felicia.
Just me. To be my friend, my lover, and my wife, I choose you above all others. You have to share my life with me in marriage. I love you for yourself. I want you to become all that you can be. I will love and respect you all the days of my life. I make this promise today in the presence of my family and friends. I, Felicia, I'm just going to give you more words. I, Felicia, take you, Troy.
I, Felicia, take you, Troy.
To be my friend.
To be my friend.
My lover and my husband.
My lover and my husband.
I choose you above all others.
Above all others.
To share my life with me in marriage.
To share my life with you in marriage.
Maybe with me in marriage. Right? Yeah. Okay, that's good. I love you for yourself.
I love you for yourself.
And I want you to become.
And I want you to become.
All that you can be.
All that you can be.
I will love and respect you.
I will love and respect you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I pledge today. These promises in the presence of my family and friends.
Well, no, did they do a good job?
Troy and Felicia, may you continue to pledge to each other to be loving friends and partners in marriage, to talk and to listen, to trust and appreciate one another, to respect and cherish each other's uniqueness, and to support, comfort, and strengthen each other through life's joys and sorrows. May you promise to share your hopes, your thoughts, and dreams as you build your lives together. May your lives be ever intertwined, your love keeping you together. May you build a home that is compassionate to all, full of respect and honor for others and each other. May your home be forever filled with peace, happiness, and love. Wedding rings. Noah, come on over here. You're going to help me. Can you do me a favor? Stand right here. Don't put your hand like this. Just one. The rings that Noah are holding are symbols of visible form of the unbroken circle of your love, so that wherever you go, you may always return to your shared life together. May these rings always call to mind the power of your love as you go about your day. May their circular form remind you that love given freely comes back around again and again. Felicia, I give you this ring that you may wear it as a symbol of the vows we have made this day. I pledge you my love and respect, my laughter and my tears, with all that I am, I honor you. Thank you. give you this ring.
Troy, I give you this ring.
That you may wear it.
That you may wear it.
As a symbol of the vows.
As a symbol of the vows.
We have made this day.
We have made this day.
I pledge you my love and respect.
I pledge you my love and respect.
My laughter and my tears.
My laughter and my tears.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
I honor you.
I honor you.
Better, 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 better I hope you have a wonderful evening.
If you haven't met anybody that you don't know yet, introduce yourselves. Everybody should leave here tonight, not as strangers, but as friends. And on behalf of Troy and Felicia, one more time, I want to thank you for being here. And now it's my distinct honor to be the first person to introduce the two of you as a newly married couple. Please welcome Troy and Felicia as they lead the procession up.
Finished the ceremony there. That was beautiful. Congratulations, Troy and Felicia. You guys look fantastic. I like the colors on it, the pastel pink. There was a few flaws that were pretty funny there. That was pretty awesome. You know, but that's raw footage. That's just natural. I wish you guys a good blessing. Good luck to the future. As you see, we're about to get a drink right now, so stay tuned, guys. Alright guys, right now I might try one of the wines that make here. You see they got the Spruce Wood Shore cups.
They got the nice imprint on there, if you guys can see that. A few different ones right here, they got the dry bracelet. They're Cabernet Sauvignon, which is like a red wine.
And then the one that took it away the most? Yep. That right there. Like I said, that's pretty sweet, but what's that called?
Chilladillon.
Alright? And then we got this Riesling right here, which is like bubbling. You know what? Let me try something that's bubbling.
Good choice.
Alright. Here you go, guys. I'm going for the bubbly Riesling. That's actually pretty nice. Yeah, I am a YouTuber. Yeah, I do a lot of fishing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but I'm just capturing this moment for my buddy here.
Alright, did I sign it too early? No.
No, hell no. Alright guys, I'm gonna sign this guest book also. My brother just signed it. Check that out. Darati! My turn.
Wait, yeah, let's probably wait
a day. What's up?
For this?
I already put the money in. Yeah. So me and my brother already donated the money to the barrel right at the beginning. As you guys can see. Blessings to you, Troy. Enjoy it. Down the hatch! Thank you.
You're welcome.
That was awesome. So we're just gonna walk around and take a look at a few things here. That's the glass mirrorless that we seen earlier. You seen that scene earlier? I'm gonna walk through here real quick. I wanna see up here. So we're gonna go into the main hall.
Is there alcohol beyond this point?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Come on.
Oh, are they taking pictures up here?
Well, are they?
I don't know if they're out there
taking
pictures.
Are they? They're taking pictures or?
No.
Right there, those guys. There's the party taking pictures there, that's amazing. Fabulous.
We should probably go up there, we should probably get in a picture.
Alright, let's check out, this is their main hall.
You got a balcony, goes waterfall, turrets off there.
What's up, brother?
Hey, how's it going?
Look at the castle doors behind him. This is actually his house. We're just renting it from him.
Yeah.
Thank you, thank you.
Anything for family.
Oh, man. So as you see, everybody's just having a good time, having a lot of fun right now. It's a beautiful place. Everything is made out of wood. If you guys actually get the chance to check this out, please come check this out. This is just amazing right here. This winery is awesome. The people treat you well here. Beautiful, beautiful scenery around. They got the waterfront there. They got a nice beach. You can actually see the grapes outside, the lineup and the rows out there. It's just beautiful here. If you guys get a chance, come out, come out.
Brother, congratulations.
Thank you, man.
Brother.
Nervous.
Nervous about what, man?
Oh, it's awesome. Great. The whole crowd, man, the crowd.
Congratulations, my brother. Thank
you, man. Yes, always.
Hey, to my brother right here. Down the hatch! Here we have
all right, guys. Decided to try an appetizer right here. This is let's see if this can focus right now. This is a chicken mascarpone right here. Never tried it before. It looks like it's on like a baguette with some like puree chicken with some sauce. That might be like a parsley or cilantro. I'm not too sure. We'll find out. That's not bad.
You should try one.
I tried a different one earlier.
So what is this?
Mini arancini.
Alright, so I'm gonna grab one of these also.
Try one of these, see what it is about. These little hors d'oeuvres here look fabulous.
That's like a mozzarella ball or cheese ball or something. That's actually awesome. Wow. Very rich inside, nice crispy outside. This is actually made perfect. Nice temperature inside, the cheese actually oozes in your mouth. Oh man, that's awesome. You can keep going around.
And next up we have Sarah and forever that I have waited for you.
introduce our first speaker, the best man, Jamie, to the podium.
How's everybody doing?
Good, brother.
Yeah. All right, hope everyone's doing all right. Y'all look great, by the way. Good job. Speaking of looking great, how amazing are the bridesmaids tonight? And you can't forget the bride. How stunning is she tonight? Wow. I was shocked. Glad all of you can make it. I kind of wish half you did. Kind of got anxiety, right? So, for those of you who don't know who I am, I'm Jamie LeBlanc, even though I'm not blonde. I'm Troy's best man. I'm also his favorite person, despite what Felicia thinks. Troy and I have met back in the 80s, on the very first day of school. We've been friends ever since.
Kato, too?
Now I know. I'm supposed to roast Troy being his best man and all, but I can't do it, man. Look at him, he's perfect. Except for one time. We're about 12, 13 years old, walking home from school. And he decided to throw a snowball at a taxi. Now this taxi, his window just happened to be cracked open just enough, man. And with his luck or his extremely good aim, he hit him right in the back of the head right here. I didn't do nothing, but I was scared, man. We both ran behind a friggin' apartment building, started hopping fences towards my house. Well, actually, he was hopping, I was running through them. And we got about maybe, what, two houses from my house? Friggin' driver and his passenger popped out of nowhere, cornered us. And if you know me, I might be big, but I'm not a fighter. So naturally, I was like, yo, it wasn't me. I was like, it was this motherfucker. Driver grabbed him up, roughed him up, and then when he was done roughing him up, he decided to throw him in a rose bush. Now legend has it, he still has a thorn stuck in his ass to this day. Helps him reminds him not to do anything stupid like that ever again. By the way, Troy, did they ever get that out? No? It's still in there. All right. Okay. Now, if I learned anything in life, actually, I didn't learn nothing. But if I had to give Troy some advice, it would be, if she says she's fine, she's most definitely not fine.
Yes!
And if she says she's going to be ready in 5 minutes, it's more like 40. So crack open a beer, or two, or three. If you know Troy, you can probably drink a whole case in 40 minutes. But always remember to put your shoes on, though. Because if she comes out ready and your shoes are gone, she'll tell all her friends how it's your fault. You're late.
Yes.
So, anyways, all joking aside, you guys really mean a lot to me. I really appreciate you guys always inviting me out to the restaurants, the zoos, the movies. It means a lot. And I hope now that you're married, it doesn't change. Oh, by the way, when you guys get a house, I'm moving in. I got adoption papers for you. I'm changing my last name to Jenkins, so there ain't gonna be no more of this. Oh, shouldn't your name be LaRouge? Shouldn't your name be LaOrange? No, none of that. LaRed? No, none of that. It says Jenkins now. And Felicia? I want a puppy. I like how the DJ played Pitbull at the start, because I was gonna name the Pitbull Mr. Worldwide. So I'm gonna end this speech by giving a big thank you to Troy for being such an amazing friend over the years. I appreciate that, bro. And I'm also gonna give a big thank you to Felicia for allowing me to be a part of your lives. If you know Felicia, she accepts nothing less but the best. So it means a lot. And if you please raise your glasses. I didn't bring your glass. Oh, thank you. To love, health, happiness, and a life full of adventure. Cheers.
Cheers.
Woo. Good job, Jamie. Woo. Woo. Woo.
Woo.
excuse me.
Okay, girl, you got it. You got it, you got it.
My speech won't be as funny as Jamie's, but it's alright. So, I just want to start by saying that I am super grateful to have friends like Troy and Felicia in my life. Friends that are truly there through thick and thin. Troy and Felicia's love and commitment to each other inspires me every day. Being able to witness such a strong connection and watch their love grow has been such an honor. I've never met a couple more meant to be. I'm grateful and honored to be a part of your lives and big day. So let's raise our glasses. I don't have one, but everybody else, raise your glass. Thank you. Alright. Raise your glass to many, many years of good health, financial success, and true love to this beautiful couple. And remember, love is life, and if you miss love, you miss life. Cheers!
Woo! Put another big round of applause for Sarah, ladies and gentlemen.
You know, many years ago, I do mean many years ago, there was a little girl named Felicia, and I came into their lives, and a son named Dustin, but it's all about Felicia's age. She grew up to a perfect person that I thought she would. We had our good times, we had our bad times. Even Troy and I had our good times, we had our bad times. Even the other night, can't bring this up. I'll just say that a hog got loose in the closet. And lo and behold, I had to clean it up. And I'll just tell you this, it wasn't puke. Oh, wasn't that either? Okay, going on. I've known Troy for the past 2 years. I've known Jamie, got to know his friends, coming over to our house, his brothers, his family. It's been a good time. It's good to know and grow with everybody. But most of all, it's good to know that I got another family joining the house. And I'm glad that Troy did marry Felicia, because I do love the kid like a son. Even though he don't know how to change his oil in his car, change the brakes, and get roughed off by his mechanics. I'm trying to smarten him up. But you know kids nowadays. Yeah. It's their way or no way. But I'm really glad that we're a whole family now, and not just half. And thanks Troy.
Thank you.
Thanks, Wayne. Everybody in this room, we're all our family, and we're glad. Thank you.
I just want to thank everybody for coming to share their special day. Nice to see everybody from out of town and local. And like Raven said, like we gained another son. Absolutely. And that's all.
Yeah, cheers everybody.
Hello. I'm Troy's mother, and I just want to say, like, I really adore Felicia. And I think it's the best thing that ever happened to Troy. Troy has his tribulations, and he really hit the gun there, Felicia. when I met Felicia's parents and some of the family, they're all a great family, and I'm glad to be part of it. And I don't know a whole lot of them, but I'll get to know them. And I wish Troy and Felicia all the best. That's it.
Beautiful wedding. They had beautiful food. It was awesome. It was actually nice and tasty. I had no complaints about that. As you guys can see, the hall was super decorative. They had the hardwood going. The place was just fantastic. They had the winery outside, all the grape vines, all that stuff. They had a lake on the back of the water. It was just tremendous. So guys, you guys enjoyed that. Check us out. Troy, Felicia, congratulations on the future. See you guys soon. Tan, you're about to get married, bro. I seen your girl catch that bouquet. I seen that. Don't lie. Tasha, you better lock that man up, all right? Peace.